Tap my name on you, girl, so I know it's real. Tap my fucking name on you, so I know it's real.
Tell a bad bitch, girl, let's go hang. You know me, bro, let's go chain. Fuck my young niggas, that's so gang. Get so drunk, you forget your name. Incense burning, smoking out of my own shit. Got black wood in my white range. I'm taking off when that light change. I'm Drizzy Drake to my old bitches. Voodoo child to my new hoes. I miss this and I want it back, so I'm all in with these new.
Where were you born and raised?
I was born and raised in Patterson, New Jersey.
Okay, shout out to P-Town.
Shout out to P-Town.
Okay, and where did you get your creative ideas from?
Well, the whole creative, artistic talent came, I was born with it, basically. Mm-hmm. And it came from my father. He's very artistic himself, you know. Okay. He used to do a lot of graffiti, and he taught me how to, when I had my coloring books, he taught me how to do, like, values and shading and coloring and stuff like that, you know. So when I was 2 years old is when it was really noticed by my parents. Like, I already started drawing images, and you know, at that age,
kids are scribbling old,
yeah, you only like scribbling and stuff, but I was already drawing images, so that's when it was,
because,
like,
I did this Biggie tattoo. This tattoo actually came out in Funk Master Flex website, and it got a lot of recognition. Even P. Diddy saw it and complimented it.
I actually got a chair, not even just a chair, but an office at a tattoo shop.
When I got the machine, the tattoo machine, for my father, I was trying to teach myself at home, and I was like, no.
Were you, like,
I'm
spearing
not
on yourself?
No, it was like fake skin. Yeah, it came with like fake skin. So I was like, you know, I was given these needles and all in these two machines. I'm like, what do I do here? Like, I never saw anyone get a tattoo. I've never had a tattoo. So I was like, I'm impatient. So I'm like, I'm not trying to sit here and trying to teach myself in the unprofessional way. Like, this is permanent. Mm-hmm. So I was like, you know, I need to start apprenticing somewhere, a tattoo shop that will train me how to tattoo. Mm-hmm. And so I contacted a few tattoo shops, but nobody wanted to take me. They were just like, you got to apprentice for 3 years, you don't get paid, you have to pay like $10,000.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And I was just like, oh, yeah. Great. So, you know, I just kept telling people, like, I'm trying to learn how to tattoo, you know. And I guess from me, like, telling people word of mouth, someone at the time that was working here was looking for an apprentice. So I came in and I showed them my portfolio, and they took me in that same day based on what they saw on my portfolio.
This is like overnight success. I don't even know what to say. I'm like speechless. Like, wow. And you know, you really worked hard at your apprentice job, obviously. And how long did it take for you to get your own office after you stepped into Writer's Inc?
I was able, I already was working out of a booth. Like, we didn't really have a lot of tattoo artists at the time, so there was space for me. But, you know, I at the time I was in this booth, and I was just, they had me practice on, like, grapefruits and stuff. So I just kept practicing. Every time I came here, after class, went to the tattoo shop, get trained, you know. And I picked it up so quick. Like, my first tattoo, my mentor at the time, he told me, he was like, you have it in you. Like, that's crazy. Like, look at your line work. And he was like, you have it. And I learned so quick. Like, I mean, my apprenticeship was cut down short.
So they cut your basically your intern's apprenticeship.
Yeah,
because you were so good.
Yeah, it would have taken me a year before I started tattooing people like that, but it was like cut in basically half because I picked it up so quick.
Very talented individual right here.
Thank you.
And what type of tattoos do you specialize in? Because I know there's like portraits and there's colors.
Yeah,
and stuff.
Yeah, there's colors, black and gray. I like black and gray a lot, like, because I'm more of a fine artist. Like, I like to do fine art, so working with a pencil a lot, that's usually what I did. So I like black and gray tattoos. I like to do portraits, anything with a lot of detail and shading, because I just feel like detail is what really brings out tattoos. So I like, that's my favorite to do.
Okay, and how many tattoos have you done since you've started partnering with Rising?
Hundreds. I lost track a long time ago. It's probably like 1,000 now. I don't know. But hundreds, yeah.
All satisfied customers?
All satisfied, yeah.
And if people wanted to get it tattooed by you, come to New Jersey, or do you do all locations?
on locations? You mean like going to other states? Not necessarily. Lately, I've been getting a lot of requests from that. Like, I had people from Canada contact me, Paris, LA, you know, and they asked me, do you travel? But I'm not going to travel and, like, guest spot other shops in different, you know, states until I get enough clients. Like, a reason to really go out there. Like, I need more than one person to tattoo. You know what I mean? So, so for now, yeah, I'm just really just working out the shop.
Out of Newark?
Yeah, out of Newark.
So if people want to come to Newark to get tattoos, is there an email or a phone number that they can call to book you?
Yeah, well, the shop number, which is 973-878-3103, or you can contact me at my email, which is Tiffany Tattooz with a Z at the end at gmail.com. And then we can give you all the information you need to know as far as booking.